Let us discuss NACSA problem. It is a very common problem, and in our exams questions are coming from this very particular NACSA problem. Now, what is the NACSA problem? There are n positive weights Wi. So that means I is ranging from 1 to n. N positive profits, so that is Pi, and a positive number m, that is known as NACSA capacity. This problem calls for choosing a subset of the weights such that sigma, where I is ranging from 1 to n, Wi xi is less than equal to m, which is known as the NACSA capacity, and sigma I is ranging from 1 to n, Pi xi is maximized. So that is a very famous problem, and here xi constitute a 0, 1 valued vector. So either xi will be 0 or xi will be 1. That means either it has been considered or it has not been considered. So in this way, the weights will be multiplied with the respective x value, whether it is 0 or 1, and their sum, where I is ranging from 1 to n, must be less than equal to m, and Pi xi, I is ranging from 1 to n, sigma of that will be maximized. So that is our NACSA problem, and we are going to solve this one. So we will be discussing the algorithm, we will be discussing some sample programs and so on. Okay, now the thing here is that, let us suppose it is actually a subset related problem. That means I am having n number of items, so I can take some of them. I can take say 2 of them, 3 of them, or it is a subset related problems. Also, it may happen that I am not considering any item, so that can also happen. So let us suppose n is equal to 4. So if n is equal to 4, that means we are having 4 items. In that case, in case of subset, we can consider 16 different combinations, because if you have one set consisting of 4 elements, then the power set, its power set can have 16 elements. So there are 16 possible subsets are there. Consider this one. So now x1, x2, x3, x4, I am taking one array which whose locations are 1, 2, 3, 4 and contents are x1, x2, x3, x4. So now you can consider this one. I think that will be good enough for understanding. See, let n is equal to 4 and we have considered items 1 and 3. It is a subset problem, I told you earlier. So I am having 4 items, 1, 2, 3, 4. Let us suppose I have considered item 1 and 3. And x, I told you that x is nothing but one dimensional array, and which is having 4 locations, that means n number of locations ranging from 1 to 4, and the respective contents at 1 is x1, at a location number 2 is x2, x3 and x4. Let us suppose, as it is a subset problem, so I have taken only 1 and 3 items. In that case, I can write in this way, 1, 0, 1, 0, that means 1 and 3 items I have taken, and 2 and 4 items I haven't taken. Why? Because already we have told that xi constitute a 1, 0, 1 valued vector. So either it can take a value 0 or it can take a value 1. So accordingly, I have expressed this one. So now you see, we are having 16 different subsets. Look at this particular tree. We are having 16 nodes. We are having 16 number of leaf nodes, rather I should say. We are having 16 number of leaves. So now you consider what is the combination here? 1 0 1 0. So it is nothing but 1 0 1 0. So that means I'm considering this very solution here. I'm considering these very solutions, and in this way, if you see that you are getting 0 0 0 0 2 1 1 1 1, all 16 combinations you are getting, and here these nodes are numbered in the diff for search. So that's why I'm having it like this: 1 2 3, then 4, 5, then 6, 7, then 8, 9, then coming to 6, 10, 11, then coming to here 12, 13, then 14, 15, coming to this 16, 17. In this way, the numbers have been made. So now, as the leaf node count, you are getting 16 leaf nodes because we are having 16 different combinations. Okay, now let us suppose we are taking this 1 and 3 elements. I can express it in this way also. That means it is known as variable tuple size formulation. The same answer I can express in this way. where we are having fixed tuple size kind of formulation means what? Let us suppose I haven't taken any one of the items, then also this array size will be 4 and consisting of all zeros. But here you see it is a variable tuple formation, variable tuple size formula formation is there. So if we take item 1 and 3, it can be expressed in this way. That means the first item x1 will be 1 and the second item at the first location will be 1 and the second location is containing 3. So that is a variable size. So now you can consider this one. See, so this 1 means I haven't taken any one of the items. So 2 means only 1 has been taken. 3 means only 2 has been taken. 4 means 3 taken. 5 means 4 taken. Consider any other one. So consider 8. 8 means 1 and 4 we have taken. So 7 means 1 and 3 we have taken. What about 15? 15 means we have taken 2, 3 and 4 in this way. So how many nodes are there in this particular tree? We are having 16 nodes. So that is a variable tuple size formation is there. So all the node counts for this particular tree is 16. And here the leaf node count is 16. So the same answer, that means considering item 1 and 3 can be expressed in two different ways. And here we have used the breadth first search. So accordingly, we have done the numbering of these nodes accordingly. So here we have discussed only the next sub problem. And in the next video, we shall discuss one algorithm of NextSAP and we shall discuss one example. Here you see, we are considering that Xi's constitute a 0, 1 valued NextSAP, valued vector. That means this particular NextSAP is known as 0, 1 NextSAP. We are also having another NextSAP, that is ordinary NextSAP, where an item can be also considered a partial weight, with the partial weight, not full weight. We can also take partial weight there, and that is known as ordinary NextSAP. Please watch the next video where we will be discussing the respective algorithm and the respective problem. Thanks for watching this one.